to be.
Yeah.
Matt Farrell. Woo right here. Just got out of a nap, right?
Just got out of a nap, yeah.
Feeling fresh?
Feeling better.
Feeling much better.
Game is at... in 2 hours.
Yeah,
about
8:30.
Let's see what we should talk about. How about the amazing season you had? Right?
Talk about that.
Yeah, how was that?
It was fun. It was obviously a blessing for me.
Your brother came home?
Your brother came home, yeah.
Crazy.
Great for great for my family.
Yeah.
Great for him. He was able to come out to some games. So it was a great season for me and my family.
Yeah. He's back in Jersey.
He is actually getting his master's right now at Louisville. The Army's paying for a program. And then after that, he'll go back to Texas where he's stationed.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, that's awesome, man. That was awesome. I mean, I saw the video. I was like, wow. This season, what are you trying to improve on?
Just always trying to improve defensively. Trying to be more of a leader this year,
yeah.
For sure, on and off the court. Trying to be more vocal. Just try to win.
You're usually silent. Like, sometimes. When I'm saying,
yeah,
like, on the court,
yeah,
you don't really yap and talk smack.
Yeah. Well, it depends on the situation. But, yeah, the coaches are always on me, you know, talking to the guys. And that's something I've been, you know, trying to do more. Talk
okay.
to the guys on and off the court.
Yeah. How was... So this summer, you're just really trying to elevate yourself, be more mature,
yeah,
about and
absolutely.
Cap, you know, seizing the last 30-plus games.
Yeah, absolutely.
Of your free college career,
yeah,
free shoes, free flights,
yeah,
free everything.
Yeah, it's been fun. It goes by super fast, though. So it's, you know, this last year, you try to enjoy it, take it one game at a time, just try to get better, you know, at everything you can.
What do you do off season, like non-basketball?
When I'm home, I usually do CrossFit.
Really?
Yeah, it's something I've always liked to do. I'm always working out at home, you know, with my buddies or my friends. But yeah, usually just getting shots up and doing CrossFit and going on runs.
You do CrossFit?
Like,
okay,
yeah.
Okay. Do you do like Tough Mudder too, or not? I obviously
no,
do two
I
different things.
Yeah, I don't really have time for those, but I'll definitely do those when I'm older for sure.
Okay.
Something I like.
Wow. Now you played in front of two games already, in front of these NBA guys. How did you feel?
Yeah, it felt okay. It felt like I could have shot the ball better. Obviously, some games your shot's going to be a little off. You got to find other ways to score. It's just trying to come out here and compete, you know, play at a high level, play the right way.
Yeah.
And not get down on yourself and just, you know, keep the positivity up. And got a lot of good players around here, so it's easy to play.
Yeah, when you went to when you were in high school at Point Pleasant, that was probably one of the best teams in the Shore County ever. A long, long time. It comes in like,
yeah,
it's like a shooting star when teams in Point Pleasant are, you know, in the Shore County are,
yeah,
really good.
Yeah, I like to think we were the best, one of the best teams,
yeah,
in the Shore Conference ever. So,
do you still keep in touch with your teammates?
I do keep in touch with the. Couple of them. One of them's a manager at Louisville, so I see him throughout the season.
Wow.
And then the other one plays at Yale. So, and then the other one plays at Iowa. So
the one that plays at Yale, he plays football.
He did play football, and he actually stopped, and now he's playing basketball.
This year, Yates is going.
He's playing basketball. Yeah.
He's finally going to basketball.
Yeah. Well, he just played this past year and got some time. Yeah, he was 6'7" man. And
really?
He's excited about next year.
Yeah, man. Because
yeah.
I was waiting for him. I'm like, I saw him. I'm like, when he was playing with you, I was like, why is this dude playing?
Yeah, he's a good,
you know,
player.
Yeah,
great
yeah,
too.
I heard about him, you know, at his time with the football team. And I
yeah.
think this is going to be good for him to
yeah,
play
absolutely.
Basketball.
He likes basketball a lot, so I think
yeah.
he made the right decision.
Yeah, he's got a better future career, like, if you want to earn a little bit
yeah.
of money. So high school's over. Notre Dame's almost over, but, you know, it's going to be a final amazing season.
Yeah, sure.
What do you envision for the Fighting Irish?
Just to try to win a lot. That's what we're going to try to do. We're going to stick to what we know, you
yeah.
know, play the way we play, trust the system, trust the guys, trust the work we put in, and just every game, take it one at a time and try to win, and then also try to get better, you know, every game, every practice.
I don't want to make you think too far ahead, but pro career is definitely in the horizon for you. That's for certain. strong ambitions for the NBA?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I'm going to try to play wherever I can. If that, you know, means getting a shot at the NBA, and absolutely I'm going to go for it. I'll work for it. Or if not, playing overseas, it's something I've always, you know, I know a lot of guys that have done that, and a couple guys that have been doing that. So it's that would be an experience for me. But yeah, no matter what happens, I'm just going to try to play and take that next step.
Your dad moved out there with you, right? To Indiana.
No, they actually just got a little apartment.
Okay.
So they can come out and see the game and stay out there.
And then he left St. Benedict's for a bit.
Yeah.
So
he's been a high school coach for about 18 years now, I think. He's coached a lot of NBA guys. Good coach, obviously. Coached with Mark Taylor.
Yeah.
Those two are best friends.
How did he?
Not sure. Really not sure. But our families, you know, were close growing up. Stuff like that. But yeah, he took off to come watch me play, which was something I didn't think was going to happen. You know, he loves the game so much. But he'll be going back to St. Benedict's right after this year. He misses coaching.
Right. So that's going to be pretty awesome. But you were, and historically, you were kind of like asked and persuaded to go to St. Benedict's.
Yeah, it was definitely a conversation in our household for about a week straight.
So what did the rest of the family, what did you feel, what did he feel? Obviously, I'm sure he wanted you at St. Benedict's, but what did you feel and what did the rest of the family?
You know, it was a good opportunity. Obviously, it's a great opportunity to go there and play. The exposure is obviously better. But, you know, I was happy with where I was. I love my coach, Nick Catania, a little bit. I love the school that I was at. I love the people. So I said, you know what, if you're that good, they'll find you. So I decided to stay.
Boom, you got to Point Pleasant, go to Notre Dame.
Yeah,
like,
and ended up working at.
And you didn't even play at any of the sneaker circuits.
Nah.
Ain't that something
never
else?
Never really ever worried about rankings, none of that.
Yeah.
So no
UIBL, no Adidas, no Under Armour. And you are the starting point guard at Notre Dame.
Yeah.
That's a pretty simple road, right?
Yeah,
you know?
Absolutely.
So your dad's gonna, once you finish, your dad's coming back.
Absolutely, he's been waiting to come back. I mean, he's still coaching me, you know, after games.
Yeah.
I gotta hear from him. So this is something he was born to do. He's a really good coach. He understands the game really well, helps me out all the time. So it's nice to have him around.
How's the experience here for you so far? Like, what have you learned? I'm sure you've been to a bunch of camps, so.
This camp's been good. Like I said, a lot of good players here. I think the best thing is just, you know, taking it all in, listen to what these counselors, the coaches are saying, and just playing hard. You know, you don't get these times back or these opportunities back, so just going out there and playing as hard as you can and just trying to make the right plays, and that's all you can do.
Yeah, most def, most def. And in terms of these young high school talent, what's your thoughts?
Get better every year. High school talent gets better every year. They're fun to watch, obviously. A lot of bright futures here.
Do you think you were going back in high school. You're going back in high school, and all these high school players are here. Where would you put yourself?
Oh, I don't know.
As honest, you know.
Yeah, it's a tough question. I definitely think the game has elevated every year. Even at college, the game changes every year. People get better, people get stronger, people get faster. That's why you got to keep working, keep up. You got to get better. But like I said, there's a lot of good young players here, a lot of bright futures. But I would say I was right there, you know,
working hard
and doing all that. So they should be excited. This is a great experience for them and also for the college counselors. But like I said before, just the most important thing is taking it all in, you know, understanding what the coaches are saying and learning as much as you can and just playing hard.
Who's your rookie of the year?
The NBA?
Yeah.
I like Dennis Smith Jr.
Okay.
I think he's got a chance, you know, playing against him, he's real good.
So
Jason Tatum, real good. I don't know, it'll be close. Lonzo Ball. I like
Vincent.
The way Lonzo plays, yeah, so we'll see.
It's gonna be stacked.
It's gonna be fun. Yeah, the NBA is getting crazy now, so.
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely getting a much more elevated even for summer league. Favorite TV shows or anything like that? Non-basketball?
Favorite TV shows, probably Entourage. definitely one of my favorite shows.
Any current in rotation?
House of Cards. Love House of Cards.
Did you finish it?
Yeah.
What'd you think?
Awesome.
She's president, awesome. Right? Awesome. He's all the way further away.
So,
what do you think next season is going to be?
Yeah, at this point, I really have no idea.
Really? So House of Cards, any other top shows you like on Netflix?
Office, big Office guys.
You like Office?
I love The Office.
Okay. It's a little dry for me, but...
Yeah, it is dry. It's sarcastic, that kind of humor, so I like that. I usually go Sopranos. It's one of my all-time favorites.
Okay, so that's a classic.
Sure. Yeah.
No Game of Thrones.
I'm not a Game of Thrones guy. No, everybody's been all over me for that.
Wow, why? So, just curious.
I don't know. I just really never had time. You got to lock in to that show.
About how many of your teammates?
Everybody.
Everybody?
Almost all teams.
So Matt Farrell, the starting point guard,
is
not
that.
A GOT fan.
I'd rather rewatch The Sopranos, honestly.
Wow.
I've rewatched that show enough. I've rewatched Entourage.
Okay.
Stuff like that, so.
If you could pick a character on Entourage, who would you be?
Probably Johnny Drama, man. That's my favorite character.
Really?
Johnny Drama, yeah.
Man
goes through a lot, and at the end he ends up, you know, getting it. And then the movie, I don't know if you've seen the movie.
I've seen it.
Yeah, so Johnny Drama is definitely one of my favorite characters.
Okay, well, I didn't expect you to pick Johnny Drama, but that's a good one.
I like Johnny
And
Drama.
What about music rotations?
Music.
You're laughing right now, so you got something I don't know.
Yeah, this might be a surprise. Music, I listen to old stuff.
Okay, try.
I'm saying like Dean Martin, Frank Sinatra, that kind of stuff.
Ooh!
This kind of stuff I listen to before games, you know, it relaxes me.
You listen to that before games?
I do.
Frank Sinatra?
Yeah, I do.
I do it my way.
Dean Martin, Frank Sinatra, all those good guys. Donna Summers.
So you actually go on a beat per minute, like beat, obviously it's a little slower.
Yeah, I have a pregame ritual and it definitely includes those guys.
No way, man. Yeah. That's crazy.
Not really a big rap guy.
No, you don't have to be a rap guy. I just didn't expect someone to go on classic
school.
Music, you know, old school music, and also like that's more of like maybe after the win.
Yeah.
You know, you beat your ACC rivals.
Yeah, right.
You know, you could pop like a cigar and do that.
Yeah, absolutely.
But you play before the game. That's okay, that's something that's really cool. Yeah. That stands out. Where can people follow you if you want to share that?
Twitter. Instagram.
Okay, what is it?
MattyFar3. It's on Twitter, same as Instagram, MattyFar3. You follow me. Got some good stuff on there. Maybe I'll show you some good music. So
best guard in the ACC.